Hey, welcome back. I'm here with Larry Batson, joining us with an animal, and I'm so honored to be with you.
Well, thank you.
We've
honored to be here.
We've never sat together.
I know. This is exciting. Now, usually Dave or Phil.
Right.
Just between you and me. They're big chickens.
They're chickens?
Oh, it's pathetic. It is pathetic. So,
right.
We're right in the middle of our school tour.
I'm excited.
You're good. We've got them.
Everybody's going to think I'm crazy, but I'm excited.
Well, I'll just give you that
okay.
one.
Okay.
Cool. All right.
What is it?
That is a Burmese python.
Okay.
And it's from Burma. Did you know that, Randy?
Yeah, I knew that, Larry. Oh, yeah.
Randy, you want to come over here and
nope.
see this?
Nope.
And this is a boa constrictor. Now, these are both constrictors.
Okay.
See, now this one's in the process of shedding the skin.
Yep, just a little bit.
And
I
if
can
you look
feel
right
that.
There on his eye, that's his eye cap that's coming off.
Oh, okay.
And
does that bother him?
No, because he'll scrape it off. Or I will, usually.
Yeah.
But this is just a baby. Of course, Randy was talking about some giant snake that he had around his neck. No.
It's very constricting, too, getting real tight. I can hardly breathe.
You can hardly breathe?
I feel like it's really looking at me right now.
I feel that way when I watch your weather sometimes.
Is it really looking at me more than I want it to?
Well, it's exploring. See, they basically live by their tongue. They
can it smell that I'm pregnant?
Probably. I never thought of that. A boy or girl?
We don't know. Maybe the snake has...
some inclination?
Yeah.
That snake will grow to be 20 feet long. Of course, this is the snake that's now invaded the Everglades.
Okay.
And what happened during Hurricane Andrew was several of the pet dealers down there basically had their livestock in greenhouses were set free because of the high winds.
Oh.
So now the pythons have, there's
they've
quite a few of them.
They've almost become native, almost.
Almost yeah. become native. But, yeah. you know, Florida has a really good freeze sometime. Of course, we hate that for the citrus crop.
Right.
That will take care of the pythons.
Okay.
And they're not going to go any farther north than northern Florida, because anywhere besides it, we get cold weather, ice, snow, and so
yeah.
forth. So it's not. You know, you're doing a masterful job. I'm telling you, I should always work with women, because the guys are just, like Randy, he's like clear over there.
My husband would be freaking out right now. But I think it's good to be able to touch animals and learn about them.
It's all about education.
Know what you're dealing with,
uh-huh.
right?
That,
respect the animal.
Does it bite, Larry? Does it bite?
It has a mouth.
Right. Did you hear that? It has a mouth. Of course it might bite.
So it does bite. Okay, it's good enough for me then.
The question is if it's going to hurt, and it actually probably would hurt.
Well, I've told the children their teeth are like fish hooks that point toward the back, and they're designed.
Yeah.
And they're designed that way, so when they grab a hold of something, it's impossible for that something to pull free.
Right.
Then immediately they constrict. And what they actually do is every time the animal takes a breath of air, the snake squeezes tighter and tighter and tighter until finally there's no way it can breathe. And it will just keep squeezing until basically it feels a heart stop beating and a lung stop moving. Then it slowly uncoils. And snakes, all snakes have the ability where their jaws can actually come apart. And that snake can swallow something 4 to 5 times the size of its head.
Wow.
In fact, they've found pythons in the Everglades that have been swallowing alligators. So they're growing pretty quick, yeah.
Okay, so you're available to come and teach about snakes and all sorts of animals,
yeah.
right?
We're right in the middle of our school program, so please call us. This is a good time right now, and we'll get you scheduled for this year. We've got a really great show this year. Well, we have a great show every year.
Do you have one thing for people who are super scared of snakes? Do you have one tip, factoid, little thing that you tell them about snakes?
Well, many people think they're slimy, whether or not, I always tell the children, their skin basically feels like a basketball.
Mm-hmm.
So that's
a good way to put it.
Yeah, and it's very smooth and dry. and they're basically cleaner than, that snake is cleaner than the fur of your house cat.
Huh.
So.
Randy, do you think I'm brave?
A lot braver than me, I'll tell you that, that's for sure.
You want to watch something funny?
Yes, of course.
We're going to go to weather.
Oh, no.
Okay, time to go to weather.
No, we're not. All right, here's the temperature trend the next several days. Up and down we go, up and down we go here. 54 Friday, 52 on Saturday.
Where are you going?
On Sunday here. So.
Oh, I've been to work, too.
No, that's okay. You can come out here. It's a beautiful snake. It really is.
It's a boa constrictor.
See, he's sticking his tongue out at me here.
It's going around.
Anyway,
run.
We'll have the forecast. You're coming up. It's going to
bust. This is just a tease?
Yeah, this is a tease.
We're not doing the whole
weather. No, we're not doing the whole weather here.
You have to just hang out a few
We'll be back, I think, after this break. Stay with us.